I'm Tiger. I'm from Dugan's Paint and Flooring Centers, and today I'm going to show you a little bit about cottage paint. This is a chalk style paint, but it is actually clay based. And the cool thing about that is it's water activated. Instead of sanding, you take a damp rag to the paint and it will actually distress the finish for you. We're going to go over some tips and tricks and basically a how-to tutorial on how to use this paint. So we have an armoire here, just some doors right now, of some stuff that I've prepped. Basically what I did, I have a sanding block and I sanded it down, cleaned it really well with a product called Peso. First you're going to want to sand, then you're going to hit it with the Peso with a rag. It is stinky, so you should open a door and wear protective gear. And I've taken all the handles off already and soaking them in a product called TSP for cleaning. I actually use the general cleaning formula for this, and it's actually going to be to remove some door handles that have some paint on them. Got a nylon brush here, just going to wipe that off. Works really well for cleaning all kinds of different stuff, including your house siding, but in this case it's to help remove some paint. Anyway, it's cleaning up pretty well, and we've got hinges and everything on here that have paint on them. These actually cleaned up really nicely. They really brightened up, and you can see some of this this discoloration is actually coming off with this TSP too. So that's kind of nice without having to change your nail holes or anything. You can go back with the same handles if you purchased a piece of furniture that is an antique. So I've already sanded some of these, but I'm going to show you what I'm doing. Basically, I've got a medium and light sanding block that I've taken just to help knock down some of the paint lines that are existing. You don't necessarily have to sand this product before coating with this product, but it's not a bad idea if there's some uneven surfaces or it's a really shiny surface. I've already sanded a little bit, but basically just to give it some tooth. That's really important for coatings, and that's why it's hard to paint such soft, smooth surfaces. I've also sanded down some edges just to help with that profile, so it helps with the doors and closing and everything. Let's see what else we got. Over here, about 20 or so minutes ago, I just painted this door, and we've got this really pretty teal color. I believe it's called Naples Blue, but it's a nice teal that we're going over this coral. I did one coat on this. It covered pretty well. I'm probably going to do another coat on it, but I'm also going to show you how to do some distressing, which is going to be over on our armoire across the way here. But as I said, it's a chalk type paint, so it's a little bit thicker. I'm going to show you how it goes on here just a little bit. I'm going to hit these areas that have already been painted, but you can still see a little bit of that cream showing through. It covers really nicely, but it is a thicker body paint, so it's really a good idea to smooth down these lines as you're painting. Try and really use a good quality brush with a good taper. Again, this is our cottage paint. It's a chalk style paint, but it's clay based. And instead of sanding, you take a damp rag to it. So let's go play. Come with me. We're gonna go across the way here to the armoire that's already been coated twice. All right, this is our lovely armoire that we painted. It was cream and coral on the inside. I've got a cup of water here and a rag, just a nice clean rag. And the trick to distressing is you want to hit the areas of the piece of furniture that would naturally distress. So I'm gonna hit these areas on the insides of where the door used to be. We're going to use this as a display purpose for our cottage paint. So we left the center door off, so easier access. You can see as I'm going here, you can see that cream color kind of showing through. And there's going to be some areas where wood grain actually shows through as well, because I sanded down a fair amount. I'm going to do the insides of these creases. One trick that I have found is the longer you wait to do the distressing, the more elbow grease you're going to use. You can see that white starting to show through now. A little more water. I know some of you are probably thinking, there's a lot of paint on that glass, but it's okay, I'll clean it up. Gonna hit these areas. You can really start to see that show. Again, this is our cottage paint, which is very similar to chalk paints out on the market, except ours is clay-based, which means there's no sanding involved once you do the distressing. Might be some sanding beforehand, but sometimes that's just better for the paint to have something to grip onto if it's a really shiny surface. Especially a light sand is important for pieces of furniture that have a laminate instead of real wood. So they have a really hard surface, and it gives the light sanding gives the paint some tooth to grab onto. Otherwise, it can try and pop off. But with cottage paint, instead of sanding to get your distress finish, you actually take a damp rag. You're really starting to see that pop now. Our plan with this piece is once we're done distressing, we're gonna clear coat it, and then we're gonna actually take a black glaze to it. So that'll be really pretty. Coming out really nice. I wanted to have multiple finishes to distress down to, especially over here. There's probably going to be some wood grain finish coming out. I thought I'd give it a little more character. I coated this on Friday of last week, so it's taking a little more elbow grease than normal because it's been a few days. But if you do it within a couple hours, it's very easy. I'm not sweating yet, but yeah. Another plus to the cottage paint is that the dry time is very quick. About 30, 40 minutes and you'll be ready to start distressing your furniture. I'm actually thinking about adding some of the gold metallic to some of these really fun areas to kind of bring out this glass inlay with the gold inside. That'd be kind of fun. Yeah, that finish is really starting to show through now. You can see here, this is one of the areas that I sanded down all the way to the wood. So you're gonna have multiple finishes popping through on this piece. I wasn't really sure about how this teal would turn out, but I'm really happy with it. I think it really makes that gold inlay pop. I'm gonna hit the front of this area because this would be a perfect spot for natural distress to start happening. This is my favorite part about the cottage paint, not just because it's easy to use, but because of the damp rag system. Instead of sanding, personally, not a big sanding fan. I actually wear a mask every time I sand. But this makes it really nice because I don't have to worry about that kind of stuff. All right. Sometimes I'll even have people use a damp rag and wipe down some of the areas that have really difficult paint lines, brush lines. Since it is a thicker type paint, it's going to be pretty difficult to have no lines, but sometimes that helps smooth it down a little bit. Kind of softening those lines a little bit, I think that really helped. If you're just joining us, this is our cottage paint, which is our chalk style paint. What I'm doing now is I have a damp rag that I'm taking to dry product. Only takes about 30 or 40 minutes to dry. And I'm using the damp rag to distress this piece of furniture. Instead of sanding, you take a damp rag to this paint. It's not wet paint. Keep that in mind. I get a lot of those questions if it's just wet paint that you're wiping off. That's not the case here. It's actually clay-based, so it's water activated. You can really see those lines popping now. Can you see it all right on the video?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. Front. I really like to get the corners really well. That's the perfect area for distressing. We've got some pre-made 8-ounce colors available, but we can also tint a lot of colors in a quart if you have a bigger piece of furniture or multiple. In this case, I did a quart. I'm probably going to use about 80% of it. You can see the wood finish popping out on this area. Get these corners really good. You can even see a little bit of the coral popping through, which is okay. I'm okay with that. I wouldn't mind having multiple colors pull through. This is the type of coating that you're going to want to add a clear coat to. The cottage paint actually has a varnish and wax option. Both come in a satin and a flat finish, so you can go for whatever you prefer. Personally, I like a varnish, and the flat is really pretty. I'm actually going to use a flat finish on this. And then after that, I'll be using that black glaze. Again, two types of finishes available for the top coat, which is a clear coat. A wax and a varnish available in satin and flat. And then there's a few different glaze colors available. There's midnight, which is very close to black. There's an umber, and then there's a molasses. The umber has a little more of a green tone, whereas the molasses is a more chocolatey tone. I'm going to use the midnight on this piece. And then use some gold accents in this area, maybe in some of these lines, just to give it a little more character. Got some distressing over here. And there you have it. This is our cottage paint. It's a chalk style paint, but it's clay based, which means it's water activated. Take a damp rag to it and get that natural distress looking. Hope you guys come by and see us at Dugan's. Thanks.